Perfect, perfect, perfect. All right, let's watch Royce Dupont. Wait, I just need to.
Actually, I stand.
How do you?
The other day, I'm on a crowded bus when a pregnant lady walks on. She looks around for an empty seat, but there are none. So naturally, I stand up and offer her mine for $62,350. We have 45 minutes left on this bus. My time is worth $150,000 an hour, and I'm even prorating this. She's stunned. And of course, your water break was fucking born yesterday. I'm sorry, you don't look familiar to me. So how is it possible that I am pregnating? She hits the floor crying. It's a total fucking mess. First, you want the seat. What's next? Alimony? I'm not paying for little Ricky's quinceañera. If you give up your seat on the bus, you give up your seat at the table.
Yes!
The other day, I'm on a...
Okay, so finally, I can toughen up you chatters, dude. I feel like I've been trying to get through to you on this business advice, but it's not hitting you. So I brought in a professional speaker, okay? Royce Dupont, one of the best and the brightest in the business world. He's a professional at this, and he's gonna get through to you. He's gonna give you the knowledge you need to excel at business and life.
To catch a predator, you know what?
The other day, I'm on a crowded bus when a pregnant lady walks.
I don't want random scrolls. I want, let's see. Okay, how about this?
Culture. Now, I know what you're thinking. What's this dinosaur know about culture? He's not hip. He's not cool. If I'm not cool, then why do black people let me use the N-word? Yeah, that's right. I got the pass. In 2011, my sister married a black guy, and on their wedding day, I asked him, my new brother, if I could have the pass. He said yes. That was 12 years ago. Out of my back pocket right here. I can say it whenever I want, guys. All right? Excuse me?
Say the word.
No. I don't want to, actually. Say when it feels right. You guys, that's, no, well, okay, well. I'll say it. You want to hear it?
No, I don't.
I'll say it.
I don't want to hear it.
Culture.
This happened with Hootat and me. I don't remember what video it was, but definitely Hootat gave me the pass. With I said, I don't want it. Don't need it. Never, not a pass that I need, want, or will use.
My old man was a hard bastard. Once he found me and my friend in our basement, high on Adderall. And when he saw the bottle, he ripped it out of my hands and poured the rest of it on the table. He said, "All right, hotshot, you like Adderall so much, prove it." By the end of the night, I'd finished the entire bottle and the Lord of the Rings trilogy extended cut. I was 6 years old when that happened. And I've been taking 80 milligrams of vitamins ever since. And no, I am not addicted to Adderall. I don't need it to do anything, all right? I just prefer it when I'm conscious. So if anyone has a fucking problem with that, they can come step up to me right now. Good.
Least stimulated chatter, bro. I unironically take 80 milligrams of Adderall a day. Bro, that's so much.
AI will be the end of us. Robots will replace humans in every sector of the workforce. Good. The other day, I was at a coffee shop, and after pouring me a black coffee, the barista asked me for a 20% tip. You know who doesn't ask me for a 20% tip when I want coffee? Mm-hmm. My Keurig.
Mm-hmm.
Yesterday, I was at a restaurant and I ordered a chicken schnitzel. And when the bill came, gratuity was included. You know who doesn't include gratuity without asking me? My air fryer.
Uh-huh.
This morning, Reach. I paid $500 for a hand job. You know who doesn't charge me for intimacy? My AutoBlow 3000, my Platinum Browser subscription, my wife. Objects don't need tips. It's there to serve. That's it. And guess what? I'm here for it. AI will be the end of us.
Our kids are too coddled for the real world. What happened to all the tough kids, huh? Where did they go? This is my son's bully. I'm teaching him how to fight. Uncle Sam says I can't hit my son. Fine, asshole. Philip can. Look at this freak. He loves this shit. Oh no, what if he gets hurt? I don't care. That's what life insurance is for. I can't do it. So help me God, my son will.
The This should have more. That's funny. This must have unironically converted somebody.
Never meet your heroes. The other day, I ran into Ron Jeremy. We were in line at a coffee shop. And we started talking, and I asked about his routine, what kind of dick pills he uses, how often he uses them. And when we got to the front of the line, Ron offered to pay for my coffee. Wow, what a stand-up guy, right? Yeah. Well, then I saw the receipt. Ron Jeremy, the guy who showed me reverse cowgirl, the guy who invented BDE, the dick pill pilgrim, had tipped the barista 25%. There he was, my hero, giving handouts to some deadbeat fucking English major.
No!
Poured the rest of my coffee in the tip jar and walked out.
Well, at least he made her day worse. You know what I'm saying? At least he made her day worse. At least something was salvaged.
All right, let's talk about edging. Men do this to supercharge their libido before a night out on the town. It makes them more attractive, more aggressive, more confident.
So well, worried about these shorts.
This is also a deeply respected tradition in Eastern philosophy. Means before. Jung means bust.
Can't be true.
Before bust. In the Art of War, Sun Tzu dedicates a whole chapter to this principle. See, he knew that self-inflicted blue balls makes you a more intimidating person.
He doesn't do that.
After all, what's more scary than a guy who's been denied his nut? And that's why I always edge before a big meeting. When I walk in that room, I need the client to know that my balls are as blue as the sky. And I'm not going to bust until I've got exactly what I want. Questions? Yeah.
Are they blue right now?
What do you think? Let's go back to the board. All right, let's talk about edging. Men do this to supercharge their...
Are you interested in therapy?
Minimal. Interested.
Thank God. I'm telling you, the weakest thing a man could ever do is change.
So true.
Because the second you change, you've admitted you're wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Women don't admit they're wrong.
That's right.
So why should you? You think I want to talk about being molested as a kid once a week? No thanks, man. No thanks. I'm good. I'm fine. I think I'm good on therapy. Thank you very much. Instead, why don't you just go take what happened to you, do it to someone else until you feel better. It's that simple.
That's just gazillion dollar advice.
Yeah, and I just gave it to you for free. Are you interested in therapy?
Minimal.
Let's say you're talking to a potential new client.
Okay,
and low
all right,
balls.
New client.
That scenario, what is the Royce choice? Do you accept the low ball or do you reject it?
Reject,
right, of course. Now that you've rejected the low ball, are you gonna counter with a higher price or are you gonna threaten him? Threaten him, yeah, exactly. And we'll threaten him by putting a gun up to his head, right? That'll do it. No, that won't do it. If you really wanna get what you want, you'll threaten him with your own life. So, how are we gonna do it? We're gonna slit our wrists like an amateur, or we're gonna hang ourselves with a noose like a man. Guys, come on, it's noose. It's always noose. Stool or desk, guys?
Stool.
Yep. Let's say you're on the stool and he's still not budging. What do? Do you actually kill yourself, or do you give the rope some slack?
Slack.
Give the rope some slack. Just enough so it doesn't tighten when you land. Reject, threaten, your own life. Noose, stool, slack, worst choice. Everyone just sit back down. Download right now. Let's
Brilliant.
Say you're talking to a potential new...
I think he's got
I was
one.
At the gym last night, and the lady at the front desk told me to enjoy my workout. Is that a fucking joke? I canceled my membership on the spot. Mm-hmm. You think I'm here to have fun? I'm wearing a diaper right now. What I'm about to do to myself should be illegal.
This is me
if these
every
aren't the worst 90
single
minutes
morning.
Of my entire life, then I didn't train harder than last time. Enjoy my workout? No. Enjoy cleaning my piss vomit pre-workout off the squat rack. I was at the gym last night, and the lady at the front desk told me to enjoy.
There's always a better
okay.
deal. You just gotta look close enough. Last month, I had a wedding in Denver, but it's ski season. Man, flights are crazy, right?
Yep.
It's cheaper to fly to LA, so I booked that. Flight takes off, a couple hours in, looking out the window, see the Rocky Mountains. What do? Shit myself. Start jerking off.
Man, it was mayhem.
Women were screaming, kids were crying. Everyone had their phones out. Whites, blacks, Latinos, they all wanted to piece of the action. The stewardess begged me to stop, but I pretended to be deaf. Pilot had no choice but to make an emergency landing in, you guessed it, Denver, Colorado. Sure, spent the night in jail, and now I'm on some stupid fucking list, but I saved $142 on my flight. There is always a better deal.
Mm-hmm.
Always.
Mm-hmm. Why are you guys doing this? This is like easy stuff. This is like day one stuff to start getting more money. And with $142, think of all the gifted subs you could do to get more knowledge. I just feel like hopefully this is opening your eyes. I'm just hoping this is opening your eyes to what's possible. I think people are so rigid in these lanes they take to try and figure out how to get success. And like this guy's showing you there's so many different ways.
Competition is good. And if you don't have competition, then make something up. Imagine that there's someone out there working harder than you.
Impossible.
For me, I don't have to. I'm a paranoid schizophrenic, diagnosed last year. Even when there's no one else in the room working harder than me, I think there is. Every time I'm pitching to a client or a boardroom, I think there's a guy right behind me pitching an even better idea. I'm on constant fucking edge, man. Boom. Whoa! Hey! Who is it? Hey!
Competition is good. And if you don't have competition.
He's got so. I only watched three of these, but they were cracking me up.
Royce, how are you going to make $8 million in 2 weeks? You're crazy. Crazy. Love that word. Crazy means that you are able to see things that aren't actually there. When I was 9 years old, I saw the twin I absorbed in my mother's womb standing at the edge of my bed as a full-grown adult. You know what he said to me? He said two words. Netflix. And this was in 2004. When I tell my friends that story, they say, Royce, we're worried about you. You actually might be clinically insane. Say thanks, Brian. By the way, how's your stock in Blockbuster doing?
So
Royce,
fucking true.
How are you gonna make eight?
So fucking true, dude. Unironically, these doubters and fakes, bro.
If you want to build for your kid's future, take out a credit card in their name, but not to build credit, to destroy it. I have 18 different credit cards maxed out in my son's name, and his credit score is a dumpster fire. Without paying upfront in cash, he will never be able to buy a home. He will never be able to buy a car, but he will have something priceless. Motivation. I started with nothing. Imagine what my son can do if he starts with less than nothing.
Good work. Good work, dude. You know, sometimes rich parents, they spoil their kids. The kid doesn't learn work ethic. Think about that. Think about that. You do the opposite, it must work.
You always want to surround yourself with friends and colleagues who are smarter and more successful than you, right? Wrong. Why would you ever want to be the weakest link in the room? You guys want to be my best friend? Yeah, he's right here. This is Chipmunk. Chipmunk lives outside my compound in Fort Lauderdale, don't you, Chipmunk? See, this guy lost everything in the housing crash.
It's fucked up.
He doesn't know anything. And he definitely doesn't know what a capitalization rate is. What was that, Chipmunk?
The net operating income over the current market value.
Get out of here. Go. Get out. No, you fucked it up. That isn't actually. Sorry.
That's a good.
You always want to surround yourself with friends and colleagues.
That's a good one. That's fucking.
If you want to build for your kid.
Wrong way.
Autism is a choice.
Bold starting
statement. Here's the autism spectrum, and all of us fall on it, right? Where do you think I fall in the spectrum, huh? Wait a second. Who's that? That's me. Is that Royce? I'm all the way over here. I'm not on the spectrum.
Holy Sigma.
I choose to not be there. I choose to not be autistic. You probably think I'm here. Or here. Or here. I'm all the way over here, man.
Well, you get the point. Let's get back to talking about which foods have the weirdest textures. We're on old bread, right? We got crunchy and slimy. Only when it's wet, right? It can only be slimy if it's wet. Why don't you come up to the board? Autism is a choice.
That's fucking good. I mean, this guy's killing it. These are really fucking true. What's funny is I read the comments and some people think they're jokes. Isn't that crazy? Like, I read the comments and people are like, oh, ha, ha, ha. They're laughing at it. They're not even learning from it. Isn't that fucking wild? It's like you can literally hand deliver knowledge, life-changing knowledge, and people will still, they'll push it away. They'll pretend it's a fucking joke. They'll, anything to not let the knowledge in their brain. It's, I hope you guys have been seriously sitting down, taking notes. Peepo G.
Well, why should they get aboard the flight before me? What? Because they got PTSD. I got PTSD.
From what?
When I was 8, I walked in on my parents.
I think a lot of kids walk in on their parents.
Yeah, well, you didn't let me finish. I walked in on my parents. Do a missionary. Imagine that. As a kid, knowing that you were probably conceived in the most vanilla sex position possible. What's more traumatic, Brittany? Watching your best friend blown to smithereens on a battlefield? Or watching your dad lay pipe to your mom like he's some loser theater kid? I wanted to get in there and show him how it's done myself.
You wanted to have sex with your mother.
Oh, God, you journalists are all the same. No, I didn't want to have sex with my mother. I wanted to fuck her so I could show my dad how it's done. Well, why should they get aboard the flight before me? What? Because they got PTSD.
Here knows what the number one time waster in America is right now. Nope, it's not Netflix. No, it's not watching porn. It's definitely not watching porn. No, the number one time waster in America is holding the door for people.
Yes.
Studies show that the average American spends 2 years holding the door for others. 2 years. That's about $2 million per person, which is about $1 billion in total. I don't hold the door for people because I'm rude. I don't hold the door for people because it's fiscally irresponsible. Opening the door for others closes the door on you. Here knows what the number one time...
This is... there's people who actually talk like this. This guy does. For real. I talk like this. This is the most real shit I've ever seen. Wait. Pull this up. Their podcast is great. What's their podcast? I mean, this is really funny. I only found out about this recently. But they... I mean, to have that many bangers in a row, bro, that's... That's heat. That's just heat. Almost Friday Media. What are they? Almost Friday TV.
Come on.
What's this?
So, it's 11:26 on a Friday night. Why am I here?
Because we're 6 hours away from the largest bubble in the history of capitalism bursting.
A few tech titans want a new house in Cabo.
Netflix announced they'll no longer support password sharing.
Jesus Christ. Okay, when does this go into effect?
We project midnight.
So what? We pay for what we watch. That's fair. It's about time someone put a fucking limit on this thing.
Well, that's the problem, sir. There is no limit.
What do you mean there's no limit?
Netflix isn't putting a limit on accounts.
She just fucking said that. Is someone gonna tell me what the fuck is going on here?
Users are going to be grandfathered in, which means you, sir, are going to be paying for every user logged into your account.
Okay, fine. All right, well, Claire, I gave you the login, so if you just log out, then I guess I'm good. Thanks for the heads up, guys.
Well, sir, you gave me your password, and I might have shared that with,
I want everyone to put their hands up if Claire shared the login with you. One, two, three, you got over there, little guy? What is that, a hand? Now I want you to keep those hands up. You shared it with anyone outside this room.
Sir, we ran the numbers, and in the United States alone, your password was shared over 1.3 million times.
1.3 million people. That doesn't even make any fucking sense.
Not people, devices. iPads, smartwatches, TVs at Airbnbs.
They add up real fast.
Yeah, do they?
If six people were to share your account at eight iterations, we're looking north of 1.5 million. At nine iterations.
How many iterations are we at right now, at this moment?
My best guess? 12. Sir, when that clock strikes midnight, that first monthly payment is going to be greater than all the U.S. dollars currently in circulation.
At least we can save you some money. Send me your login again, and we can revoke the privileges of everyone on your account.
We were the first family on my block to use Netflix. Back then, if we wanted to watch a movie, we had to wait 5 days for the U.S. Postal Service to hand-deliver us DVD.
This is a, what's the movie? Margin Call. This is a perfect Margin Call parody, by the way. If you haven't seen Margin Call, you have to watch. I mean, at least watch this scene with Jeremy Irons. It's so good. This is you know, when the music stops. And you hear that? Silence.
Now my smart fridge plays Emily in Paris on repeat 24/7.
Sir, if you give us your login, we can take care of this.
Jenny, give me a car service for Phil Brexen. We need him here 10 minutes ago.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, Phil Brexen? The intern from 2 years ago.
Why are we trying to contact a fucking intern?
Dear God. It's not even.
It's not his fucking account.
Jesus, Todd, you make seven figures a year. You can't even get your own fucking account?
Sir, we found Bill's cell and address. Try calling, but no luck.
We should just let the intern foot the bill. We're not liable.
All of us are liable. We have streamed entire seasons of shows. We mortgaged that boy's life so that we could watch Stranger Things, Outer Banks, F is for Family, The Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt!
We have to tell him to change his password.
Sir, I spoke to Phil's landlord. She says he hasn't left the apartment all week.
Thank you, Janet.
If we do one good thing in this life, it's this. You two, fix this.
Go!
Sweet mother of Jesus.
I already know.
Just getting my money's worth.
You wanna put the remote down? Maybe we can.
Go!
Oh, orange is the new black. Be funny.
No!
Please just let me watch!
If you don't change your Netflix password right now, you will never financially recover from this.
Tiger King.
Change your password.
My ex changed my password months ago.
What?
She was just using me for my account. I don't have access.
Then just cancel your card.
Cancel my card? All my accounts, all my passwords. It'd be such a hassle to relink everything. I can't do that.
That's it. Give me your phone.
No! No! Please! How am I supposed to finish the Attack on Titan?
Go on Hulu or pirate it.
What?
He's zeroed. Let's get out of here.
Wait. I don't have Hulu. How do I?
I'll send you my login.
That's great. These guys rule. Wow, I'm glad. It's a new discovery. These guys are funny. Yeah, the Black Mirror song. You know, interestingly though, I think this is in my predictions too, which I do have to do. God damn it. That I just present them. is the password sharing stuff for Netflix has been a massive success. They cracked down on it. Everyone was like, oh, who knows? People might leave. I'm going to get fed up. And they just didn't. They all just, they just booked it. And so everyone else is going to do it too. Like it's just increased subs. I want to see.
I want to tell you guys a little story. Two boys grow up in the same neighborhood. One rich and one poor. The rich kid is gifted an iPhone on his 9th birthday. And by his 12th birthday, he is fully addicted to porn. Now, the poor kid, he can't afford an iPhone, so he doesn't discover porn until he's a fully grown adult. You want to know where those two men are now? I'll tell you. The rich kid inherited $10 million and now runs his dad's hedge fund. His wife has double D's, and both of his kids go to Dartmouth legacies. As for the poor kid, the kid who had no access to porn, gunned down in gang-related violence. Coincidence?
Can't be. It can't be.
I want to tell you guys.
It can't be. I mean, that tracks. Two boys That tracks, bro. Unironically, that makes a lot of sense.
How busty is your wife in 5 years? Studies show that there is a direct relation between your wife's bustiness and your annual income. So let me ask you this. How busty is your girlfriend right now?
Pretty busty, I guess.
Let me see.
Let me see. It's crazy.
Double it. No one is going to take you seriously if they know your wife has B cups. How do you expect to get a promotion, let alone make a sale, if everyone knows your wife isn't busty as hell? The customer's just going to feel bad for you, man. What kind of idiot is going to buy from a guy whose wife doesn't even have back problems? Wake up, muchachos! How busty is your wife?
The back problems thing I heard is real. I mean, it's like, some women get reductions just because it's fucking, it legitimately actually causes long-term back pain, which is crazy that you could like, I mean, of course, in theory it is, but like, I guess it's more common than you think. How did you just find this out? No, I didn't just find this out. I'm just saying, I know. Do your fingers have the same problem? No, I don't have back problems from carrying around my very normal hands. All right. Wear a backpack with a dumbbell in it. I guess that could work. If you have gigantic boobs, could you just wear a really heavy backpack and then it balances it out? Does that solve the problem? Like a counterweight? I'm just thinking out loud here. Does make cardio harder, might hurt the shoulders. Now you have shoulder problems. That reminds me of Happy Gilmore, where the old lady is like, they're making her knit. My fingers hurt. Oh, did they hurt? Well, now your back's gonna hurt because you just pulled landscaping duty. All right, let's see. Yeah, I think we got them all.
I want to tell you guys a little story.
There's no more. There's no more old. There's no more scroll up. We might have got them all. Wait.
All right, I'll sell it to you for.
We didn't get
$10,000.
The most valuable.
No deal.
No deal. All right, guys, no deal on the final offer, which means our back's against the wall, and we have to use a DuPont ultimatum. I haven't had a drink in 14 years, but you made me feel pretty powerless right there, so I think I'm just going to relapse in front of you. Last time I had a tequila soda, I was found in the net under the Golden Gate Bridge. The time before that, I tried to kill a room full of people. So, okay. Bottoms up. CNL, asshole.
I'll take the deal.
Take for $10,000?
Yeah.
Done. You know what?
Whoa.
All right, I'll sell it to you for $10,000.
Easy, no dude.
All right, guys, no deal.
Get the deal and the drink.